This Power BI and Power Automate collaboration is really changing the way how we are working. Last week, I made a video about how you can send an email by extracting the PDF from the Power BI report to the end users. And in this video, we'll discuss about how you can send the PDF according to the row level security defined in the Power BI and apply the same logic in extracting the PDF and send it to the users accordingly. It's an awesome, right? So we'll discuss all this in this video. Stay tuned for that. Hi, I'm Mohammed Adnan and welcome to my channel, Tyke18. In this channel, we discuss a lot about Power BI, Power Automate, Power Apps, and a lot more about the SQL Server, Actress, Excel, and YouTube as well. If you are visiting first time to this channel, or if you haven't subscribed it, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. Now let's get started. I'm not going to begin from the beginning of how you need to export the data into PDF, but just the part of the row level security here. So when you go down here, there's an options called the identities here, identity data set, and identities role item. So before to that, I want to tell you one thing. So basically, this is the report of the COVID second wave, which I developed, and here I define the three roles here, that's Delhi and Tamil Nadu. If you want to see the data of Tamil Nadu, I'm just clicking here and test as role. So here you can able to see only the details of Tamil Nadu here in the tables below as well. If I change this to Delhi and apply, it just applies only to Delhi here. And when I change it to all, these are the three rows I have. It gives me all India details. So for that, you have to define the role in Power BI Desktop and publish into Power BI Service. That's one thing. And the next thing is you need the dataset ID, right? For that, basically you need to go to your dataset and click on the more options and then settings. If you go there and in the address bar, you get to know about what is the dataset ID here. So the dataset slash whatever the number you have is your dataset ID. So copy these two things. One is the rows, whatever you have created, and other thing is the dataset ID. As the regular procedure, you have to define the users inside to these roles. So now coming back here to Power Automate, here you can see the identities username. So basically, if you hover here, it gives a message. The effective username reflected by a token for applying row level security rules. For on-prem model, username can be composed of alphanumeric characters or any of the following characters. You can use these ones. Also, username cannot contain spaces. For cloud model, username can be composed of all ASCII characters. Username must be up to 256 characters. So as we are going to connect this to your on-prem, so I'm going to use the regular email ID. Example, powerbi@tyke18.com. And for the identity dataset, initially I thought that it is a dataset name, so I tried that, but actually it's not. It has to be a dataset ID, like I have shown how you can extract the dataset ID. So you have to copy and paste the dataset ID over here. And the next thing is identities role item. Here you need to define the role for which role you want to extract this information. So for now, I'm extracting the information for Tamil Nadu. So whenever this flow runs, it will extract the details of Tamil Nadu from the dataset and send it to the users who you have assigned this role. So for now, I'm assigning this to Tamil Nadu. So whenever this flow runs, it extracts the details of Tamil Nadu from the dataset and send the emails to the persons to whom we have defined in the below email section. So mainly, these are the three things which you need to define, and then the regular process, the email thing. So you need to define the users whoever you want to send the email. You can define it here. Once you do so and you run this flow, you will get an email like this. So this is an example of the email which I received from Power Automate. So if I open this PDF file, I have the details of only Tamil Nadu here instead of full complete India details, only Tamil Nadu states here, and also the details in the table also is filtered by the row level security. This is cool, right? So this is how you can able to apply the row level security in Power BI and Power Desktop, and it goes through the Power Automate in order to extract the information based on the row level security, and you can send it details extracting to PDF into an email. So this you can, so from Power BI with the row level security to Power Automate and extract to PDF and send an email. If you like this video, just click on the big thumbs up button. If you're new to this channel or if you haven't subscribed it, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. But make sure you turn on the notification on your devices. Share it with your friends and colleagues. If you have any queries and feedback, just post it on the comment section below. Thanks for watching. Keep learning. See you in the next video.